Welcome to the 2012 IHSAA and IFOA State Football Training Video. I'm Robert Falkins, Assistant Commissioner of the Indiana High School Athletic Association. We have prepared approximately 100 plays divided into 9 categories, which were pulled from the televised games during the 2011 season, including every state final football contest. These plays are shown to help prepare and instruct on-field officials in Indiana with our sole goal to promote better and more standard officiating across the state. Many of the plays are examples of exceptional officiating. A few will show officiating which leaves something to be desired. Our intention is never to embarrass any person or crew, rather to help you learn, improve, and become a better official, not only as an individual, but as a crew. Good luck to you and your crew during the 2012 season.
The receiving team, number 87, blocks the opponent from behind in the numbers at the point of attack, the 32-yard line. The player is in chase mode when contact is made from behind. Referee, incorrect positioning on a try or field goal. You should always be facing the front of the holder, not behind him. In five-man mechanics, the short wing to the sideline behind you will go back to the upright. Referee, incorrect positioning on a punt play. The potential kicker is right-footed, so you should line up on his kicking foot side. Line judge, contrary to popular belief, correct no call for a horse collar tackle. The defender has to pull the runner to the ground using the inside back or side collar of the shoulder pads or jersey. The pulling action is not what put the runner down. Great call on the runner touching out of bounds short of the line to gain. Head linesman, good call for an illegal block in the back at the point of attack on the punt return. Defender is in a chase mode and initiates contact squarely in the back at the 47-yard line. Good preliminary signal by the referee. Back judge, good position straddling the goal line and ruling on a punt that is fielded in the end zone. In National Federation rules, the kick is dead when it crosses the goal line. Well done. Back judge, an excellent call for a block in the back at the spot of the catch. Good recognition of two hands in the back, freeing the punt returner to go upfield.
the exchange.
Well, the timeout has been taken. Referee, a correct announcement of this penalty does not include the team color. In this case, it should be kicking team or receiving team. Also, there is no need to confer with the captains on this penalty. The kicking team will obviously accept it. Back judge. On punts, your starting position should be 5 to 7 yards behind the punt returner and 3 to 5 yards to the linesman's side, since the line judge should be flowing downfield at the snap. You want to get an angle as the ball comes down to the receiver so you can see a muff and box the play in with the line judge. On this play, you're too far behind and still on the move, thus limiting your view. Good job of putting the ball on the yard line to start the next series. Crew, onside kick mechanics. There is no need for a beanbag when R touches the ball beyond 10 yards. The only time the beanbag should be used is if K touches the ball prior to it going 10 yards. Also, all four officials on the restraining lines should work the entire play off the field and hold your starting positions until one team secures possession of the ball. Head linesman, block in the back at the point of attack at the 27-yard line that springs the ball carrier up the sideline. This should be in your line of sight as the ball carrier has turned the corner. Referee, let the umpire get back into his position before you blow the ball ready for play. Line judge, good call for personal foul, unnecessary roughness at the end of the play. A secondary act, an unnecessary throwdown of the ball carrier. Nice job of continuing to officiate the play out of bounds. Referee, good announcement. Infraction, offense, defense, not color, and penalty associated with the infraction.
Dead ball, personal foul. Defense, 15-yard penalty from the end of the run, and a first down.
Referee, unnecessary charge into the quarterback, hands to the face of the passer after he has thrown the ball. Thus, violation of Rule 9-4 of roughing the passer, which would result in a 15-yard penalty and first down. Not calling these fouls is a potential for injury and possible ill will toward the opponent. Head linesman, do not punch receivers who are on the line of scrimmage. That mechanic is to be utilized when receivers are off the line of scrimmage. Referee, the right tackle is beat by the defensive end and pulls him to the ground at the point of attack. Crew, great no-call for UNR at the end of this play. The quarterback is a runner, is trying to get more yardage, and isn't out of bounds. The hit by the defender is legal. Crew, good piece of officiating and patient whistles on the strip of the football by the defense. However, don't stop officiating around the pile at the end of the play. Number 33 on defense takes a cheap shot at number 82. This should be a dead ball personal foul for an unnecessary hit against a defenseless player. Back judge, umpire, and line judge. A51 seeks out an opponent and unnecessarily hits him near the pile after the play is over and knocks him to the ground. This should be a dead ball personal foul, UNR, enforced against the offense for 15 yards. Keep your eyes up at the end of the play and look for contrasting uniforms coming together. Back judge and crew. The ball carrier is pulled down to the ground using the inside back of the shoulder pads. This is a textbook horse collar tackle that should be called. Tackles like this often lead to serious injury. Head linesman and back judge. The pass is beyond the receiver out of bounds when the defender performs high, unnecessary hit on him. The defender is not playing the ball and could have avoided the hit. This should be a personal foul, as hits like this lead to injury and ill will between opponents. Head linesman, good position and coverage on a pass play near the line to gain. Excellent personal foul call for illegal helmet contact on an opponent. Players are restricted from initiating illegal helmet contact, a butt block, face tackle, or spear. The referee has too much discussion with the offended team. This is a straightforward 15-yard penalty added onto the end of the run and should require no conversation with captains. Also, incorrect penalty enforcement. The penalty occurred with 4 seconds remaining in the third quarter. After the 15-yard penalty, the clock was started correctly, but an untimed down should have extended the period due to the accepted penalty, instead of going to the fourth quarter without a snap. Crew, good no call for UNR as the tackler makes a good clean hit on the receiver. Nice job of seeing the whole play. Head linesman, the wideout to the top of the formation is on the line of scrimmage and beats the snap count. This play should be shut down for a false start. Do not let this continue on as an illegal motion penalty. Head linesman. Third receiver to the top of the formation is off the line of scrimmage and beats the snap count. This play should be shut down for a false start and not allowed to continue with an illegal motion penalty. Umpire, good call for false start on the center. The flinch draws a reaction from the defense. Attempt to throw your flag to an area unoccupied by players to avoid hitting someone. Head linesman, good call for false start on the left tackle for missing the snap count. Utilize the preliminary signal to your referee to keep the pace of the game moving. Referee, good strong announcement of the foul. Line judge. The wide receiver goes in motion, doesn't beat the snap count, or faint starting upfield. It appears to be too technical for a false start. Good use of the preliminary signal to the referee. Head linesman and line judge. Good call for encroachment as the blitzing defender enters the neutral zone prior to the snap. Good use of preliminary signal by the head linesman to notify the referee of the foul. Referee, the motion man beats the snap count and starts upfield before the ball is snapped. We would prefer that a false start be called in this case rather than motion since he appears to reset in the backfield. Crew, the offense has 11 men as part of the formation. Then run a 12th man onto the field. He is stopped and part of the formation. Play is allowed to continue, and illegal participation is the call when the play should have been shut down for illegal substitution. The difference in the yardage for the two penalties took the offense out of field goal range at the end of the half for an untimed down. Head linesman, the right tackle blocks blitzing defensive end below the waist at the 46-yard line. Even though both players started in the free blocking zone at the snap, this block is illegal because it doesn't take place in the free blocking zone, the 36 to the 42-yard line. Excellent job of recognizing and calling this safety foul. The left tackle grabs, restricts, and takes the feet away of the defensive end at the point of attack. Referee, good mechanics of watching the opposite side tackle with four receivers in the set. Left tackle number 70 has an inside grab, jerk, and takedown of the defender. Correct call for offensive holding. Line judge, good mechanics of working the entire play in the white. Crew, an illegal block in the back is called on slot receiver A87. The block appears to originate in the side of the defender and not in the back. Ensure that you see the whole play from the start to finish and not just the end result. Referee. The defensive end appears to overpower the left tackle and knock him to the ground. What type of restriction was there by the left tackle to make this a foul? Back judge, good position on the goal line, but try to get a little more distance between you and where the pass is to be potentially caught. Umpire and line judge. The right guard and the right tackle perform a chop block on left tackle after the snap. The right guard is engaged high with the defender as the right tackle goes low. Referee, could you have helped on getting this safety foul? Back judge, good call for DPI. Defensive player plays through the back of the defender with significant early contact. Head linesman and back judge. Good call for DPI. Defender has early contact with the receiver while not playing the ball. Back judge and line judge. The wide receiver to the bottom of the formation goes downfield, blocks an opponent, and the ball is thrown to a teammate beyond the line of scrimmage. This is offensive pass interference. Line judge. Good call for DPI on the defender. Early contact, barring of the arm while not playing the ball. Back judge, you should be down on this too as you have the best look from the angle that you have. Back judge, good position and coverage on this long pass. Good call for DPI on number 27 as he arm bars the movement of the receiver while the ball is in the air. Be distinct on your signal once the interception is made. The initial signal looks like the pass is incomplete.
Play there, but pass interference. Defense.
15-yard penalty. Automatic first down.
Good announcement by the referee. Try to not be moving when announcing the penalty. Crew, excellent job starting the series on a yard line. Line judge, correct mechanics for holding the line of scrimmage during the pass play. The quarterback is beyond the 26-yard line, therefore an illegal forward pass is the correct call.
Indianapolis now, this is the big thing.
On the offense, 5-yard penalty, loss of down, second down.
Referee, incorrect signal given when reporting. Illegal forward pass is arm behind the back, not downward arm in front, which is roughing the passer signal. The foul should be enforced from the spot of the line judge. The wide receiver number 4 is asking to be on the line of scrimmage. He covers up the tight end number 10, who goes downfield on a pass beyond the line of scrimmage. This should be a foul for an ineligible downfield. Also, all officials who work on the sideline should work the entire play off the field. Referee, good call for intentional grounding. The quarterback throws the ball to an area not occupied by an eligible receiver in an attempt to save a loss of yardage. Also, try to keep your starting distance on the throwing arm side of the quarterback as he drops back. Correct enforcement of 5 yards from the spot of the pass and loss of down. The quarterback flips the ball forward to the receiver and it hits the ground before securing possession. Good job of getting together to ensure this is ruled an incomplete pass and not a fumble. The clock continued to run until the shutdown by the line judge for the conference and should have been reset to 1:19, which is the time when it hit the ground, not 1:08. Good use of the auxiliary box to reset the ball to the previous spot, left hash, B45-yard line. Head linesman, good flow downfield when you read pass. Referee, good no call for intentional grounding as A85 was in the area of the pass. Also, good no call for illegal touching by an ineligible receiver as A57 didn't touch the pass. Umpire, good movement to the line of scrimmage when you read pass. Head linesman, good flow downfield when the quarterback stays in the pocket and you read pass. For five-man mechanics, we would like to see you stay downfield to help cover the deep sideline instead of flowing back to the line of scrimmage on the late rollout. The umpire will have the illegal forward pass and the line judge can help on an ineligible downfield. Excellent long-distance call for the incomplete pass as the receiver was out of bounds when making the catch. Tight, tough call with a five-man crew. The receiver gains possession with his left foot on the ground, crosses the goal line, then steps out of bounds with his right foot. By rule, this should be a touchdown, not an incomplete pass. Back judge, this is only a 15-yard pass from your initial position. Attempt to get stopped, straddling the goal line when the pass comes down to the receiver. Headlinesman, good position and coverage on a pass to the sideline. Nice, smooth demeanor and mechanics. We would have liked to have had you wind the clock in this situation as the runner's forward progress was stopped inbounds before he was driven backwards out of bounds. Umpire, great job of looking back to the referee to determine the status of the ball before signaling or blowing the whistle on this fumble. It would have been very easy to assume an incomplete pass, thus having an inadvertent whistle. Just remember to give the stop clock signal once it's determined that the defense recovered the fumble. Nice job. Umpire, good job of moving up to the line of scrimmage when reading pass. Head linesman, you should flow a little bit more downfield rather than holding the line on pass plays. The line judge does a good job of holding the line of scrimmage when reading pass and a good job of using one signal, stop the clock, when the line to gain is achieved. It appears that the ball should be spotted at the B48. Ensure you give the receiver all the yards he earned. Back judge, good position and coverage on this pass over the middle. There's no reason to beanbag the spot of the interception in National Federation football as there are no enforcements from that spot. The only exception to this is if the action takes the play inside the 5-yard line on each end of the field and momentum is involved. Crew, good job of spotting the ball for the succeeding play with the nose touching the 10-yard line. 4 snaps to get the ball into the end zone. Well done. Good job of reverse mechanics on an interception. The referee gets to the goal line and the line judge boxes the play in. In most cases, the use of the beanbag is not condoned at the end of the play, but in this case, the line judge does a good job of dropping it and heading toward number 74 to keep the dead ball action from escalating. A nice job of not having a flag on this play, as it is merely a talk-to situation. Head linesman and umpire, a nice job of flowing when reading a pass and moving up to the line of scrimmage. Back judge, keep your starting cushion during the play. This is a 30-yard pass play that ends up right on top of you. You should be at least 15 to 20 yards downfield when the pass arrives. Back judge, keep your initial cushion on pass plays downfield. You want to stay between the receiver and the goal line he is trying to achieve. A good call for DPI as the defender grabs and restricts the receiver's movement with the ball in the air. Don't worry about the ball after the play. Give the referee a preliminary signal so he can announce your foul.
Let's see what the officials say.
Pass interference. Pin.
Well, the teams are heading to the sideline, so apparently that will be the end of the third quarter. And it's been all Carmel in this football game as we go to the fourth quarter of play. Now let's see.
One on time down.
Yeah, here we go.
In and on zeros.
Referee, your announcement should be penalty, team, then enforcement. Good knowledge of needing an untimed down for an accepted penalty at the end of the quarter. Head linesman, good use of the wind mechanic when the ball carrier is down inbounds near the sideline. Head linesman, good job of flowing to the goal line at the snap as the line of scrimmage is inside the 5-yard line. Crew, this is a tight, tough play, but the ball carrier appears to be stripped of the ball prior to being down. Patient, non-quick whistles is the key to seeing the whole play and getting it right. Line judge, excellent movement to the goal line and umpire to the line of scrimmage when you read drop back pass from the 6-yard line. Great position at the goal line for catch where the receiver comes down right on the goal line after being hit by the defender. Only advice is to slow down on your touchdown signal until the receiver comes to the ground, because if the ball pops out when he hits, the pass would be incomplete. Umpire, don't turn your back to the line of scrimmage when backing away from spotting the ball. Head linesman and line judge. The snap is from inside the 5-yard line, so your initial movement at the snap should be to the goal line. Correct ruling of forward progress, not a safety on this play, as the runner's movement was stopped at the 1-yard line. Crew, when the offense runs the polecat formation with no kicker, the officials under the uprights should spread out along the end line to cover the potential play. If the offense shifts back to a scrimmage kick formation, then transition back to the uprights before the snap. Line judge, good movement from the line of scrimmage to the goal line at the snap. Excellent job of seeing the entire play. Quarterback sneak is on top of players and extends the ball across the goal line plane before progress or a body part hits the ground. Well done. Referee, slow down and check off with your wings before giving the stop clock signal. Having conflicting signals could negate the play and cause confusion on the field. Head linesman and line judge, an excellent job of flowing to the goal line at the snap since the line of scrimmage is inside the 5-yard line. Try to work a little deeper into the white off the sideline once you're near the pylon. Well done. Head linesman and line judge. When the ball is snapped from the 10-yard line and in, you have to start flowing to the goal line at the snap due to it being uncovered by the back judge. The proper position for the head linesman when the runner crosses the goal line is at the back of the white area, goal line extended. You need to at least signal touchdown when the runner is into the end zone. Crew, defensive holding is called at the top of the field on a scramble to the bottom of the field. The foul was incorrectly enforced from the spot of the foul, the B42, when it should have been from the end of the run, the A44, which resulted in awarding 14 unearned yards to the offensive team. Crew, time critical point at the end of the half with the offensive team out of timeouts. The pass is caught inbounds several yards short of the line to gain. The The line judge inadvertently stopping the clock allows the offense to obtain 4 extra seconds they shouldn't have, which results in a field goal attempt. It is extremely important to know where the line to gain is in time-critical points of the game. The line judge has incorrect mechanics of punching the receiver on the line of scrimmage. We only punch receivers off the line. Headlinesman, good call for an illegal block in the back at the point of attack on the punt return. Defender is in a chase mode and initiates contact squarely in the back at the 47-yard line. Good preliminary signal by the referee. Back judge, good position straddling the goal line and ruling on a punt that is fielded in the end zone. In National Federation rules, the kick is dead when it crosses the goal line. Well done. Referee, good call for roughing the holder. The defender wipes out the holder on a successful kick. Try to minimize discussion after the foul, as the offense will definitely take the enforcement as it results in a first down. Crew, opening kickoff of the game. An unnecessary hit by the kicking team number 26 near the pile well after the play is over. Continue to officiate after the play is over. Hits like this need to be penalized as they can result in injury or could lead to ill will later in the game. Umpire, good dead ball officiating of getting to the two opposing players on the ground and preventing the situation from escalating. Correct judgment for a no call for personal foul unnecessary roughness on either player. Head linesman and line judge. Correct call for illegal formation. Less than seven players on the line of scrimmage. Three receivers to the bottom, the quarterback and running back off the line. Good strong announcement by the referee using the correct signals.
I was going to just ask you about the Warriors.
Legal formation.
What do you think about this team this year?
Offense.
Well, what's that say about the mid-conference and the fact that, you know, anybody can...
Head linesman, good call for false start on the right tackle due to a flinch. Crew, the foul occurred with 2 seconds left on the clock at the end of the quarter with the clock running. Once the foul was enforced, the clock was started on the ready for play and allowed to run out. Per rule 333, an extension of the period should have occurred because there was an accepted penalty on the last time down of the quarter. Referee, good call for offensive holding on the running back. He grabs, restricts, and takes the feet away of the blitzing defender. Good strong signal and announcement by the referee.
Tackling, because I can tell you, Evansville Modern Day, they teach kids how to tackle. You just can't rep that up in practice.
Coach Gable's done a great job.
Good use of the wind signal when the runner is down short of the line to gain inbounds. After the touchback, the runner had to get to the 30-yard line for a first down. Head linesman, good judgment on a backward pass and use of the beanbag to mark the end of the related run where the quarterback threw the ball from. We would like to see you punch the pass backward as well when you deem it backwards. Back judge, good positioning and spot on the long pass that ends just short of the goal line. Good use of the stop clock mechanic as well. Line judge, the offense has to get to the 32-yard line for a first down. Good job of giving the receiver all that he earns on forward progress. Were you stopping the clock because the line to gain was reached or because the runner got knocked out of bounds? Head linesman and back judge, good call for incomplete pass. The receiver did not have control of the ball while in bounds. Head linesman, good position and coverage on the play that ends near the sideline. Good use of the wind signal as forward progress is stopped inbounds and giving the receiver all the yardage he earned. Head linesman, good job of picking up the end of the run spot from your crossfield mechanics and getting all the way to the yard line before squaring off and coming into the field of play. Back judge and umpire, good depth by the back judge on a pass over the middle. An excellent job of keeping spacing but getting stopped when the ball gets to the receiver. Good job by the umpire of spinning around when the pass is thrown to help on this possible trap. Well done. Crew, good no call for illegal touching of a pass to an ineligible receiver. The pass was backward, therefore there is no foul. Nice job. Line judge, good job of getting back to the pylon on the interception. Try to stop at the goal line extended instead of going into the end zone to get the best view of the ball breaking the plane. Crew, defensive holding is called at the top of the field on a scramble to the bottom of the field. The foul was incorrectly enforced from the spot of the foul, the B42, when it should have been from the end of the run, the A44, which resulted in awarding 14 unearned yards to the offensive team. Crew, time critical point at the end of the half with the offensive team out of timeouts. The pass is caught inbounds several yards short of the line to gain. The line judge inadvertently stopping the clock allows the offense to obtain 4 extra seconds they shouldn't have, which results in a field goal attempt. It is extremely important to know where the line to gain is in time critical points of the game. The line judge has incorrect mechanics of punching the receiver on the line of scrimmage. We only punch receivers off the line.